Hey, what's up, everybody? This is episode 25 of the Equine Photo Schools podcast. We are now doing video podcasts, so check us out on YouTube and in your favorite podcast player. So whether you're watching this on YouTube, go check out the podcast, check out all the other previous episodes, the last 24 episodes of the podcast. They're all going to be on your favorite podcast player, whatever that might be. I'm sure that we are broadcasting virtually to all of them. So today's topic is about FAQ videos, training videos for your employees and customers, kind of like we're kind of training our customers here too. And that is really what started Equine Photo School. Like, I was doing these kind of videos for my staff, for my employees, my friends that were coming to help me. A lot of them were requesting like something, like teach them how before they get here, before they come to an event and sit down and they're in front of customers. Like, they wanna know, like, what's this job gonna be like? Talk to me about it, whatever. So I was making some training videos for them. I was teaching them Lightroom. I was teaching them how to use my website, Zenfolio, all kinds of stuff. Just whatever it was that we needed to do, whatever I needed them to do at Ole's Images, I was training them to do it. And that led us to Equine Photo School, because I was like, well, I'm making these for my crew. Why don't I make them for you and your crew and whatever? That has led to now making courses. I now have a new course out on equinephotoschool.com/courses. And that is gonna be on mastering horse portraits. Now, we go through three different things. Just wanna talk about this real quick with you guys. We go through confirmation pictures and action shots, running them around the arena doing stuff. And then even black background shots, how to nail that in camera so you have very little to no editing. It's great. I mean, there's very little to do after the fact because we just nail it right there. You're doing a professional job. You're not, you know, him-hawing around. And you know what to do. You know what to do next. And you know what you're going to do after that. And then you're going to go home and you're going to deliver them super fast photos. So I've also, as a bonus to that course, I've included the high volume, high speed workflow course, a $25 value, but it's super helpful. It really just delivers that instant gratification that your customers want. So whether you're working in the booth or it's after a private session, after somebody's hired you to take pictures for them, either way, you use this high speed, high volume workflow and you can get those pictures to them really super fast. So without further ado, let's get into today's episode. First of all, why? Why are we here? Why are we talking about this? Why did I even start making these videos, right? So there's a lot of reasons, right? For one, they are shareable. They're easy for me to share to my people and for my customers to share to their friends and family or whatever, right? So it makes it really easy to get this message to spread. If that's what you want it to do. If you set these to unlisted on YouTube, then only those that have the link to it can access it. So if you're doing more private things, like for your training for your crew, you don't want the whole world to see, then you can set these parameters differently on YouTube so only people with that link. So if only the people that I want to share this to can see it, which is super cool. It's great for training employees. That way, you know, everybody has access to YouTube and it's, I list all these on YouTube, either listed or unlisted or some variation of that. Now, you wanna play with the different settings and see, you know, read the description, what they mean, and things change on YouTube frequently. So just check out what's going on there when you get there. After you've uploaded your video, it'll walk you through the steps, pretty straightforward. So just check that out and, you know, think about first what you want to do. What's the intention of this video? Is it just to train your employees before they come to work? Or is it to show your customers this new product, right? So there's a lot of that. The other thing is I was getting a ton of just questions that were the same all the time. Like, how do I shop online? How do I, you know, how do I buy this? What's a vivid metal? What's a statuette? That sort of stuff. So I was making videos for that kind of thing. And then when the customer would ask that, I would just go to my YouTube channel, grab the link to that video, paste it in the message, and say, here, check out this video I made just for this question. That is so much better to do than just trying to text it out, to describe it via text, especially if you're like me and you got 1,000 things going on and you're in a big hurry, and sometimes you're just like, it's this cool product, you gotta have it. And they're like, that wasn't a very good description, I don't think I need it. And then you've lost that sale. Instead, what you've done is you've taken a few minutes to record a video, you edit it, it looks nice, you put up some nice things, you have like the actual product, like you would show it, you know, here, and you would say, hey, this is a thing that I do, and you could add some B-roll in there, you know, you could come in nice and close and get those detail shots, and then that lets them see no matter where they're at in the world, no matter where you're at in the world, you guys don't have to physically be in the same space, and you can still sell them on this product. So I love it for that. I've sold a ton of statuettes, a ton of vivid metal, custom collages, basic collages, you name it. If we do it at Ollie's Images, you know, and it's like not your normal, just a print, everybody knows what a print is, so I didn't make any videos about that. I've never had a question like, what is an 8x10? Like, okay, nobody ever asked that. But anyway, if people are asking questions, you know, kind of like jot these down. I use Evernote, and it's a great way to like just hold all of your notes, all of your ideas, all your stuff in there, and I just have a FAQ page. And when people ask questions, boom, 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 I just write them down in that page, and then, you know, you can add a little tally mark or whatever. You can add stuff to them so you know how many times that question's been asked, and once it's been asked like several times, you're like, hey, listen, this is probably a question that I need to make a video on. It would be easier for me to answer. See, this is great because it is you, in your own words, describing the thing that you do or sell, or teaching your employees in your words the way you want it done. So instead of, some people are like, well, I use this other guy's training videos, and you guys, you know, you guys at Equine Photo School, you guys might be using my videos to train your employees, which is super cool. I've definitely, you know, I'm definitely glad you guys do that. But if you don't do that, or if there's some variation, if you're like, oh, I like what Ollie does, but not all of it, you know, maybe you don't like everything that I have to say, then you can go and make your own videos based on what I said and based on what somebody else said and how you combine it into your thing and make it your thing. And then you give that to your employees and say, here, this is me teaching you in my own words how I want this done. This is the task. This is the order, the steps, the order of operations. All that kind of thing can be done. You can do that yourself. Even if you just are filming yourself with your iPhone or whatever phone it is, and you're just editing it there, just as a, you know, save it as a favorites on in your camera roll, and then you can quickly text it to them and say, here, this is how we do that particular little thing. Super quick, super easy. So let's start with training videos. These are videos that we use at Ollie's Images to train employees before they come to work, typically. Sometimes they're videos that they can watch at work if they get hung up on something, they stumble during a process, and they need to quickly scrub through the video to find that point where they kind of, you know, stumbled a little bit, and then they can start there and then watch it and then figure out what to do. So there's quite a few examples of this. We'll get into them in just a second here. But this lets your crew kind of mentally prepare for the day. It lets them, especially if they're new, especially if they haven't come to work for you yet and they're a brand new employee, typically it was my friends that are coming to work for me, right? And they want to do a good job. They actually are the ones that requested, will you make me a training video or something? Like, teach me how to do this. And originally, you know, I was just doing it over FaceTime and trying to walk them through it. But then, you know, I don't always have time to do that. And it was kind of, they weren't always getting the best training, right? So by pre-recording it, I could watch it myself. I could make sure that all of the steps, I could plan it out. You know, I use these big note cards here to kind of plan out what I'm going to do, even for this right now. So I was going through all of the steps, making sure that they are here written down, and then going through that with them on camera. And I was able to do a screen record, like if it was a Photoshop deal or a Lightroom workflow, whatever that might be, I could bring up those programs here on my computer and then walk them through that as if they're looking over my shoulder. Super easy, really helps them kind of get familiar with what we're gonna do at Ollie's Images once they come to work. Even if it was a booth crew kind of stuff and I was just wanted to teach them how to, you know, sell pictures to customers, how to take an order, that sort of a thing, I would make a video on that, just a quick, you know, it doesn't have to be a long drawn out thing, just a quick down and dirty, like this is how we do things, so they can kind of mentally prepare for the weekend. So for some examples of videos that I've made for Ollie's Images employees is like how to use Dropbox. So how we go through, add photos to Dropbox, send that link to the producer or a customer or a magazine, whoever. So we're doing that to, you know, transition over after an event is done or after each round is done. You know, some events want pictures of the round winners, of the average winners, of the fast time, whatever it might be. So we're doing all that in Dropbox via Dropbox. So it's all there in one place to just transfer easily. We can send a link one time, and then as soon as we upload pictures, they're instantly in everybody's pocket. Super fast and easy. Another thing is like Zenfolio order approvals. I was having my booth crew fulfill orders online as the event progressed throughout the weekend, as well as during the week in between, you know, in between events. I have employees that never actually come to work at the event, but they're just virtual employees. They would get a copy of the hard drive a day or two after an event, and then from then on they would just copy that contents onto a hard drive that they kept, right? And then those people were able to help me fulfill orders while I was driving down the road. While I was off doing something else, making more money doing another thing, these employees were helping me by taking care of the orders that were coming through online. So I had to teach them about the order approval process and how to edit in Lightroom and the whole workflow of all that stuff. Speaking of Lightroom and the workflow of Lightroom, I would go through and do a screen record like I talked about earlier and screen record the entire process, start to finish. I would film me taking the memory card and putting it in the slot even, you know, like even simple stuff like that. That's like, hey, here's a little trick to do this easier. And so you don't, you know, destroy my card reader by putting it in wrong and forcing it and making, anyway, lots of problems there. Don't get me started. So I would just teach them the whole process in this video, step by step. And then at the end, when I had the video all done and ready to put on YouTube, I would watch that one more time and make some notes and say, at time, you know, 1 minute, 25 seconds in, this is when I started talking about importing to Lightroom or whatever it was, you know, and just kind of make a little list of some of the highlights, some of the things, like a table of contents, right? So that way they could scrub if they were in the heat of the moment and working at Ollie's Images in the booth with customers breathing down their neck. They could go to that video and go, oh, this is where I messed up. This is where I got hung up. And they could scrub to that point, watch that little section, and then get back to work, right? So it made it so they didn't have to reach out to me. And because I'm out in the arena, I can't come to the booth to rescue them. So it was just like one more layer of assurance to set their mind at ease and let them think through their problems. There are other examples to use, numerous, numerous examples. But another example would be like lens choice. So what kind of a lens do we want to use for this particular kind of shot? Say we're doing award shots, right? I want them to use a certain lens. I typically use that 24 to 70 mil, but it depends on what kind of awards are going on. We might need a 16 to 35. We might need a 70 to 200. It just kind of depends on how much room do we have to work with? How wide is the shot going to be? We kind of work through that. So that people in my booth didn't necessarily have to be photographers, but as long as they could kind of figure out some stuff, or even if they're really new at photography, they didn't really understand, you know, all the different nuances, they can watch this video and understand how this system is going to work. So what I need them to do, what kind of, you know, a lot of times I would already know where the awards are gonna be at, what they're gonna look like, et cetera, et cetera. But in the event that things change, because they do, you know, producers, everybody, things change, arena, hosts, you know, whatever. Whatever it might be, something happened. You know, I've had the wind, you know, we were set up outdoors to do outdoor, you know, whatever, award shots. And then all of a sudden it started raining. So we brought that all inside. So I wasn't able to make the change. I was still inside shooting the event, right? But my booth crew had to make a change. So I taught them how ahead of time to think through this and pick the right lens, pick the right lights, do the right settings, set all this stuff up so that I didn't have to be there. So just a quick training video. No sweat, made it really simple. The next thing is FAQs, or frequently asked questions videos. These are videos that are great for sending to customers. They're gonna ask a question like we mentioned earlier. They're gonna, you know, ask about what other cool products do you have? And you can say, hey, I've got these cool products. Let me send you some videos that I've made on them. Here's a statuette video. Here is a custom collage video. Here is a vivid metal video, whatever it is. So you can just fire back and send them video after video after video that you have on YouTube, and then they can just share those to their friends. You say, hey, listen, I'm working with my sister to get my mom a Mother's Day gift. What would be cool? You know, she ran barrels at this event where you were at the other day, and what would be a cool gift for her for Mother's Day? And then I would say, hey, here's a code. You know, use this code at Mother's Day 20 to get 20% off, or whatever it was, whatever the code might be. And fire them a code and that video and say, look, the statuette, super cool. Your mom would just love to have this little statuette of her on her mantle or wherever, at her desk at work. I don't know, whatever it is. And you can send them the video and it goes in depth, goes into details, gets up close, all the cool stuff, and explains to them exactly how cool this product is, right? You could also do a walkthrough of a process. People always ask me, how do we buy pictures online? I feel like it's super, super simple, but some people, you know, they get a little confused when they start shopping online and they don't want to mess up. They're scared that if they click the wrong button, it's going to take all of their money, right? So you just give them a simple little screenshot walkthrough. So it's basically like them looking over your shoulder, and they can see, like, this is step one. This is how I find my pictures, right? This is how I do this or that or the other thing. And then you walk them through the whole process on how to buy one picture, and then you get them back so they can buy more than one picture. And then you let them go through the whole checkout process and all that, and just simplify it, streamline it for them, make it simple and easy for them to understand and digest, and they will order from you time and time again. It's a wonderful deal. That makes it super simple. And instead of you trying to go on your phone and type a quick answer on how to do this or that, or getting frustrated with all the people asking you the most basic of questions, you can just go through and send them a quick video. Super easy. So as you can see, there are a ton of reasons, and I'm sure you could come up with many, many more. Let me know what ideas you have come up with while watching this video or listening to this podcast. I would love to know some ideas that you've got. Maybe I can implement them into what I'm doing, or maybe we could share them with the others and we could all learn and grow that way. So if you haven't already, subscribe to the YouTube channel, subscribe to the podcast, and I look forward to talking to you guys again next time.